In this video, we're computing the integral of x times e to the 3x dx. And this is a classic integration by parts integral. So the main point of integration by parts is that we're integrating a product of two functions. So we have x for our first function and e to the 3x for our second function. And we're going to pick one of these functions as the u for our integration by parts substitutions, and the other part of the integral will be called dv, and that includes the dx part. So the natural choice here is to choose u equals x, and then the rest of the integral is going to be dv, this differential quantity, because it has a dx tacked onto it. And generally speaking, as long as your u is going to get simpler when you take the derivative, you've made good substitution choices in your integration by parts. And that's the case here because the derivative of x is 1. It got simpler. So we let u equal x, and then we need the differential of that, which means the derivative of that times dx. So the derivative is 1. When we multiply by dx, we just get dx. Then dv is the rest of our integral, that's e to the 3x dx. Okay, and then v is given by the antiderivative of this. So the antiderivative of e to the 3x is found just using a quick chain rule backwards approach. That's 1/3 e to the 3x. Because if I differentiate this thing, the derivative of e to the 3x with respect to 3x is just e to the 3x. And then the chain rule tacks on a factor of 3, the derivative of 3x. So now we apply the integration by parts formula, and I get u times v for my first term. That's 1/3 x e to the 3x. Then I have minus the integral of v du. So v is 1/3 e to the 3x, and du is just dx. And we can move the 1/3 out in front, and I have the integral of 3x dx. So now we're computing the same antiderivative. When I take the antiderivative of e to the 3x, I get 1/3 e to the 3x. It's just the chain rule backwards. That produces another factor of 1/3. So I end up with a negative 1/9 e to the 3x for that second term. And this was an indefinite integral, so I should have a plus c at the end of it. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.